Welcome to Melbourne, where qualifying for the Australian Grand Prix should be getting underway shortly. And as we wait, poised for the start of what will hopefully be a thrilling qualifying, why don't you tell us, Anthony Davidson, about the things you can do to really get the most out of a car in a session like this?
Well, you're largely limited by the Parc Fermé regulations, of course. Back in the old days, pre-2004, you'd work on both a qualifying setup and a race setup over practice, and then swap them over after qualifying. So the race car was quite different at times to the qualifying car. Nowadays, though, you have to find a compromise that works for both. There are a few things that you can still adjust during the session, such as the differential, the brake bias, and the front wing angle, but that's about it. So it's more about optimizing what you do have and adapting your own style to suit the track conditions.
We don't think you'll have any trouble getting into the next session, so don't push too hard. All personnel be aware, car leaving. Fantastic. That was the fastest lap. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. That's the fastest lap so far. Well done. Engine fired, we're set. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. All clear the garage, please. Car ready to leave. What happened? Let me know you're okay. Thank you. There's only one lap of fuel remaining,